He also, of course, took that decision around international aid. Now, actually, that's at a time when the UK next year is meant to be exercising global leadership in a whole range of different areas. So a lot of British businesses have been very critical of that decision. But really, the main problem here is that, just as you said, the UK is in a very, very difficult economic position. We're experiencing the worst economic downturn in the G7. We needed to see really resolute action to build up confidence, to get those jobs being created again. And unfortunately, we just didn't see enough of that from the Chancellor yesterday.
But just to focus on this particular issue, you've just mentioned, of course, the public sector pay freeze. And if you are a teacher or a police officer and you are going to see a freeze in your income, can you not imagine that a number of those people would think, you know, it's absolutely right that unfortunately we can't keep doling out money in foreign aid if we can't even reward those who have worked the hardest? Because as we know, the NHS is excluded from the public sector pay freeze. So the other public sector workers who have worked the hardest through the pandemic, if we can't even give them some kind of boost.
But the Chancellor himself said yesterday that we need to ensure that we have that consolidation of public finances in the medium term, not in the short term. But what he's doing right now is taking these decisions for the short term. Now, that's a big problem, because bodies like the IMF have said very, very clearly now is the worst time to be putting the brakes on the car and slamming it, putting it into reverse. Actually, what the Chancellor needs to do is to build up that economic confidence. That's what's needed now.